And now let's see what happens when we put sales tax on a sales receipt. What's the result of charging sales tax? Well, the sales tax payable account and the chart of accounts will increase. The agency's or vendor's balance of what we owe them will increase. The customer obviously will pay more. But let's take a look at the file before we record the transactions with sales tax. We can open the main report, the trial balance, push A for all, and we can see that we already have $21,820 in income before we activated sales tax. The other important report is under vendors, sales tax liability. Push A for all, and you can see that the total sales so far are all non-taxable, $21,820. But of course, these reports will change as soon as we record a sale and include sales tax. For example, let's imagine on January 9, we did 10 hours of video for Alan Arby and Alan paid us with check number 61. From the main menu, click Customers, enter Sales Receipt. The date is back on January 9th. The customer is Alan Arby. Notice New York State sales tax is what's here after we choose the customer, Alan Arby. The check number that he gave us was 61. The item of service was video 10. Notice there's $240 in tax for a $3,000 video job because New York State charges 8%. $3,000 is what we've earned in video income and $240 is what we owe in tax. After we click Save and Close, you can click Yes to refresh the reports and you can see sales tax payable shows up for the first time in the trial balance as $240. You will also notice that New York State tax shows up as $240 New York State tax for the taxable sale of $3,000. So the first $24,820 of income in this file were non-taxable sales. And this $3,000 that we just earned right now are taxable sales, and the amount of the tax for New York State is $240. Now, you don't always have to agree with the defaults. For example, imagine on January 10, we did 12 hours of editing for Betty Boop, and she paid cash. Betty's tax is New York, but just on this invoice, we're going to change the tax to New Jersey to see what it looks like. From the main menu, click Customers, enter Sales Receipts. The customer is Betty Boop, and as you notice, we set up Betty to have New York State tax. The date was January 10, and she paid us cash. The item was editing, and the quantity was 12. Now, right now, the tax says $134. That's because it's set for New York State tax. But what I'd like to show you is at the moment you make the receipt, you can change it to New Jersey tax, and it will become $100. You can change it to 6% instead of 8%, and it will adjust the tax, and the total of the receipt will be just adjusted accordingly. Now, if this is New Jersey tax, $100, and the sale itself is $1,680, let's click Save and Close, and we get this more warning. Do you want to permanently change Betty Boop's tax? Well, the instruction specifically said that it would only be for this invoice, So in this example, we will click no. Now, when we look at the trial balance and we see sales tax payable has increased. When we double click, we can see that we have $240 in sales tax from the January 9 invoice and $100 in sales tax from the January 10 invoice. When we look at the sales tax liability report, we can see that we now have $4,680 in taxable sales compared to the $21,820 that was earned before we activated the sales tax. But the most interesting thing is this column, tax collected. $100 of New Jersey tax, $240 of New York tax equals a total of $340.80 sales tax, which is equal to the trial balance sales tax payable, $340. So the sales tax payable in the trial balance shows the total tax owed, whereas the sales tax liability report shows how much each part of that $340 is owed to the different tax agencies. Let's try one more. Imagine on January 11, we did 14 hours of video for Candy, who paid us check number 22. Now let's change her tax to New York and make it permanent. From the main menu, click Customer, enter sales receipts. We make the date January 11th. She gave us check number 22, and the customer is Candy. Now notice, as soon as we chose Candy Charles, New Jersey tax came up at the bottom of the invoice, because that's what we set as Candy's defaults in a previous video. The item was video, and the quantity was 12. Let's just double check the instructions. Oops, 14. That's okay. And of course, she's taxable for New Jersey tax, $252. But if we change her tax to New York state tax, notice the amount increases because New York tax is 8%. At the moment we click save, well, before we click save and close, notice it's $336 that will increase New York state tax owed and also increase the general sales tax payable. At the moment we click save and close, we get the warning message that we changed Candy Charles' tax item. Would you like to have this information appear next time? If we click yes, that means the defaults are changed for Candy in the customer center, and now Candy has New York state tax. Notice sales tax payable increased by the amount of tax from that sales receipt. And when we come back here, we see that the reason why the trial balance shows $676 in sales tax payable is because this $676 sales tax payable is split between $100 owed to New Jersey and $576 owed to New York.